We want to do everything we can to both protect ourselves legally while at the same time working with the movement to call attention to what's happened.
Joe Osbaker, I wanted to ask you about the other house that was raided. Just looking at an AP piece, FBI agents in Chicago took a laptop and documents from the home of Palestinian-American anti-war activist Hatem Abudaya, who is the executive director of the Arab American Action Network. His attorney, Jim Fernandy, said the government's trying to quiet activists. The case is really scary, he said. Abudaya is an American citizen. Can you talk about your work on Israel-Palestine, who Hatem Abudaya is?
Well, I actually have to talk about my wife's work. My wife is a longtime solidarity activist in the Palestine Solidarity Movement.
Stephanie Weiner.
Correct. She was also subpoenaed. And really, everyone in the anti-war movement in Chicago knows Hatem. If you look back at online at video of the protests here, of thousands of people marching when Israel assaulted Gaza 2 years ago, Hatem was the MC at almost every major rally, and the Arab American Action Network was the first center of the Arab community in the city, founded back in the late 1960s and early 1970s. So Hatem is the most prominent Palestinian activist in the city of Chicago. It's no surprise that they targeted him.
And you're organizing, Joe Osbaker, around Colombia. In a minute, we'll be joined by Ingrid Betancourt, who is, well, as you know, held captive for more than 6 years. But what about your work around Colombia, since it seems that Israel, Palestine, and Colombia were major focuses of this FBI raid?
Well, I actually think that I should defer that question to Jess, who has much more experience in Colombia solidarity work.
Jess Sundin in Minneapolis.
Yeah. The anti-war movement has long been concerned with places that the U.S. funds wars abroad. And there's a major civil war unfolding in Colombia, and it's the third largest recipient of U.S. military aid. So Colombia is very much an issue for the anti-war movement. I have traveled to Colombia and understand that it's the most dangerous place in the world to be a trade unionist. And in fact, anyone involved in the social movement there is viewed by the government, as well as the paramilitary death squads, as a rebel and treated as such. And so I know that the investigation is very interested in travel. I've traveled to Colombia and trying to establish some sort of organizational ties, which there aren't. But that said, I do support the Colombian struggle and have been very involved in that.
Colleen Rowley, how do civil rights compare, what you're seeing today under the Obama administration, to President Bush, someone you certainly blew the whistle on?
Well, I can't talk for another couple hours here, because that's how long it would take me. I actually urged the FBI from early on. I even wrote a chapter, Civil Liberties and Effective Investigation. And unfortunately, these warnings have just been largely—of myself and many others—have been largely ignored. Even the 9/11 Commission focused. Three of their recommendations out of 41 were on creating a privacy and civil liberties oversight board. And Bush, pulled the rug from under that board early on. And Obama, 2 years later, has never appointed any people, any of the five seats to that board, which is just incredible in light of what's gone on, even including the revelations of torture and warrantless monitoring. What people need to do is to basically ask for more than just an IG investigation. They need to ask for Congress to actually take on something like a new church committee. And that's actually been asked for. Barbara Lee, I think, actually had a proposal a year ago for something like that. So we should all contact our elected representatives and ask for Congress to take on greater oversight of this, what's going on.
Well, we will certainly continue to follow this case as it unfolds. I want to thank you, Colleen Rowley, former FBI agent, whistleblower named Time Person of the Year in 2002. Jess Sundin and Joe Ausbaker, thanks so much for being with us. I know this is a very difficult time for you. Both of their homes were raided, computers, notes, other things taken. That happened on Friday morning. And, of course, we'll continue to follow both these cases. Coming up next, after break, we'll be joined by Ingrid Betancourt. She is the former Colombian presidential candidate who was taken hostage by the FARC and held for more than 6 years. She's now just written her memoir. Stay with us.